Resuming my game. I have no idea how to do this. Plot so far. Mad poisoners. Moriarty. Suspicious looking people. A poison soup kitchen. And the imminent death of the London poor as we know them. There you go. You have now as much idea what the hell's going on in this game as I do. Right, so I have got a lot of wooden targets.
I can't see a keyhole to open this hiding place.
No, that's because I've got to set the targets up in the right order. So, only the elephant can stand among predators and risk turning his back on the king of the animals. The gazelle is dead. It's dangerous to turn one's back on the lion. A hyena waited for a hare to come out of its burrow, which he will never do again because they both died of hunger. That has upset the giraffe because he and the hare were neighbours. So, the hare and the hyena need to swap. Sitting at the edge of the jungle, the chimpanzee didn't notice a vulture that grabbed him with his claws. The giraffe witnessed this scene. So, edge of the jungle, vulture, giraffe, hare and hyena are neighbours. Possibly. Possibly not. That's a predator. That's a predator. So, okay. The gazelle needs to do that. Which means that the lion must have been looking at the gazelle. The elephant stands among predators and risks turning his back on the king of the animals. No indication really as to who goes on what side. Of course, that's a predator as well, but the giraffe witnessed the scene. Gazelle is dead. So that's a predator, but that needs to go next to the giraffe. The chimp was at the edge of the jungle. Kind of means one side or the other. Could be the other side. let's see if the chimp will go at the other side, which means it's got to be looking that way around. But the chimp didn't see the vulture. The vulture saw the chimp, so the giraffe witnessed it, and it upset him. The hare and the giraffe were neighbours. He turns his back on the gazelle is dead. Maybe. Why isn't that light?
I can't see a keyhole to open this hiding place.
Okay, let's reset this. Start again. That's the edge of the jungle. Means that has to be the giraffe. That has to be the hare. That has to be the hyena. Facing each other. That has to be the elephant because he sits below, between predators. The giraffe. The gazelle turned his back on the lion. The lion ate the gazelle. Oh, okay. They're not dead. So the chimp is dead. The hare and the hyena are both dead, and so's the gazelle. Yes?
There we are. Nay. It is simplicity itself.
Hadn't killed them.
The Stan's slush fund. I wonder what happened to the owner that he should leave without his savings. Maybe I'll save this, having got that right. Just, you know, out of general sense of paranoia. And my unerring ability to discover every single villain in the entire place. It's open.
Yes, so go.
This building was a menagerie. I'm in the service passage.
Okay.
This cage has been blocked with planks so that the interior is hidden from view.
So things can happen.
Old bandages.
Okay.
A key.
Ah, hello.
A large syringe for animals of a considerable size, evidently. Everything points to that cage having been used to treat sick animals.
Okay. Can I close the door? No. Okay.
What a smell. There must have been wild animals here once.
And there were scumbags outside.
I pity the animals that were shut up in here. The cages are very narrow. Nothing of interest here.
Except for the scumbag.
Apparently it's a medicine chest for first aid, I presume. Closed.
Well, here's a thought. I have a key. Here we go.
The only thing intact is this bottle of ether. If the guard sees me, he will sound the alarm. I must neutralize him, but discreetly. There are probably others, and a fight would attract their attention.
So ether, then. Do I have anything in the way of cloth? No, I don't.
There. That should interest our guard.
Thought so. Ooh, let's go back in here. Does the money need to go anywhere else? Yes. Because the guard is apparently just that dense. Lead him around. So I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to do without getting myself killed. Until we can sort out how far around he's going. He's coming quite a long way this way, isn't he?
Good. My little stratagem is in place. All I need to do is to wait for him to come back here.
Okay, I can cope with cutscenes. Sorry. Yep. How's that? Any better? I believe I can fly. You really are that dense.
to shut him up, and quickly.
He's going down. Kerflump. The subtitler looked and went, "You want me to do snoring?" Come on, Holmes.
Perfect. Thanks to the ether, this baller will sleep for a long time.
Not much ether. That baller is likely to be dead. But hey. That does at least give me the free run of the funfair. We've got the boxing saloon. I've just come out of the your lucky day. No idea what that is. Okay, nothing to see here. Can't get in there, despite appearances. No, I've never had any luck with that fish. Pardon me, by the way. It definitely wants you to go to the application on its own first. Apparently I'm headed for the freak show. Picture show. Whatever. One of us. Oh, hello. Okay. Magic walls. I feel I want a stealth mode.
Another guard. This place is full of them. I cannot risk a confrontation. He'll see me coming and I'll lose the element of surprise. I'll need to find a way to trap him.
Cool. Yay. Hello, CISO. Yes, basically I had forgotten the dead part of the descriptions. Which essentially means you lie them down like they've been shot. Pardon me. I need a drink. Apparently I should have zigged when I should have zagged. Yes, all I've done is sorted out the targets in the firing range and drugged the guard. Apparently locking him in a cage and then chucking a bottle of ether in is the kind of subtlety expected by the world's greatest detective. Right. Ahem. Apparently, freaks and geeks.
They must have exhibited those poor wretches in these cages and presented them as being dangerous.
Dangerous. What did I just pick up? Rope, pliers. What is that? Oh, that's the crank handle. Okay. Part of a crank. There's a bod still in there.
I wonder what this machinery is used for. A rail system is fixed to the ceiling, and a hook is hanging from it. It must be used for moving heavy and bulky objects.
You're right there. You are right there, dear. So, will the crank work?
Thanks to this...
No. Obviously, I need to build something else. So,
be careful of those boxes. They are balanced, one on top of the other. It would take very little to knock them over.
Oh, dear. Chekhov's gun.
Bearded lady.
Okay.
Bearded lady.
Right. Any special reason for that?
This large, empty aquarium held the fair's main attraction.
Mermaid.
The mermaid, Poseidon's daughter. The mermaid.
Okay. I wonder if there's anything in the mermaid's cage. I wonder if I can get into the mermaid's cage. Oh, apparently I can. I'm seeing an insanely complicated scheme develop.
People must have been locked up in here, and they are certain to have been mistreated.
I've got nothing to use with it. So, can I get up?
I suppose it was on this small stage that the monsters were presented to the public. Ah, here's something interesting. Hans's diary.
Monday the 8th. Moriarty is behind schedule. I've been waiting for 2 days now for the materials I need for my research to be delivered. He will have to get a move on if he wants me to take over the work he's started. My patience has its limits, and no, I'm not doing this in the god-awful German accent. I have filled in my time by reorganizing this place. An old fair sideshow exhibiting monsters. I don't know if Moriarty is aware of the irony of the situation. To calm my impatience, they brought me a subject at the end of the morning, a dirty old tramp in good health. He will do. I'm going to test the last evolution of Moriarty's poison on him. Night has fallen and the test is finished. We had to kill the subject. Mwahaha. His continuous roaring annoyed the boss. I can understand now why he needs my genius to help him advance in his research. The subject was in such a state of murderous madness he became completely uncontrollable. He didn't seem to understand the simplest orders. It's a long way from the desired result. Tuesday the 9th. The material still hasn't arrived. On a brighter note, I received two new subjects, a man in his 50s, thin, hairy and toothless, and another who was younger but equally repulsive. We should be thanked for cleaning such parasites off the street. Wednesday the 10th. I was woken in the middle of the night by screams and laughter which seemed to be coming from the freak show. Two of Moriarty's men, completely drunk, had locked the two subjects up in the same cage before giving them a bowl of the poison. They were amusing themselves by betting on the combat's outcome. I hurried off to warn the boss, we can't waste material this way. I rather liked their expressions when they woke up a few hours later, in the cages, except instead of the tramps. It must have been the worst hangover of their lives. Thursday the 11th. I have finally received the material and the ingredients which will allow me to modify Moriarty's poison. The first experiment is going to be very simple. I'm just going to make a few drops of my famous will-annihilating poison and mix them with Moriarty's poison. We will see if that's sufficient to make them obey orders. It's a failure. The subjects didn't even have the time to kill each other. They died less than 30 seconds after being given the poison. The effects of the two poisons didn't add up as expected. On the other hand, I'll keep the dosage in mind. A poison that fries the brain so quickly cannot really be called a failure. Friday the 12th. I worked all night to develop the second dosage. This time I distilled the curare differently to obtain a less powerful derivative. I also modified Moriarty's poison, but he was not very open about its composition, so I had to improvise. Another failure. The subject did not die immediately, but he was as uncontrollable as the others. The only difference of note is that the wounds and the tissue damage did not get any worse after the poison was taken. Well, that's of no interest. We're not here to treat them. Moriarty assisted in the experiment. He didn't say anything and left in silence. He wasn't pleased. I think he's starting to get impatient. Saturday the 13th. Moriarty is becoming impatient. The idiot doesn't understand anything, and he dares to question my talent. He was the one who came to find me to modify his poison. He'd been trying for weeks without success, and now he wants me to succeed in 2 days. We had an overheated discussion about it, but I finally got him to admit that a chemist has no choice but to bow to the rules of science. It's nature that sets men the rhythm, and not the other way around. I tried another dosage. This third test was a semi-failure. This time the subject alternated the bouts of madness with a fall of blood pressure. He went from enraged to comatose in a few seconds. I think we're on the right track here. Sunday the 14th. Moriarty doesn't want to wait any longer. This morning he openly threatened me. He's given me 2 days to obtain a conclusive result. He gave me to understand that past this deadline I will go from being the researcher to becoming the guinea pig. I'm confident enough. I was able to worm the components of this poison out of him, and as I thought, the problem isn't with my creation, it's with his. His idiot apprentice chemists who worked on it made so many mistakes in the dosages, I'm amazed it produces the effect it does. I've spent more than 10 hours going over the dosages of Moriarty's poison, and I have finally obtained something sufficiently pure to be mixed with my personal composition. A new subject must be delivered as soon as possible. I can't wait to see the results. I succeeded! The problem wasn't with my poison, but with theirs. It was much too strong. I modified it, and the subject proved to be obedient without losing any of his fury. True, he did eat his own hand, but this time it was because we told him to. It's the first time I've seen Moriarty smile. We have obtained the objective. At any time, Moriarty can poison a large section of London's population. The choice of Whitechapel area seems a natural one. It's there that the greatest number of the starving can be found. So, at the given moment, these thousands of ragged soldiers can invade the city and spread chaos such as the British Empire has never known. Nothing will stop their fury. The devastation will last for the time that the boss needs to seize power and place that pathetic clown Woodville on the throne. Then the killing frenzy will stop of its own accord. I programmed the poison to last for 48 hours. After that, the subjects will join their victims in the paradise of the flea-ridden. Monday the 15th. I'm now going to be able to mass-produce this wonderful poison. Moriarty has set his men to cleaning up the warehouse below. It's a perfect place, and it even has an enormous reservoir in the roof. The boss came here in person to pay me part of the money I was promised for my work. I'll have the rest when his plan has succeeded. I will soon be incredibly rich. What a dreadful diary.
That Hans is the only real monster ever to have frequented this attraction.
Yep.
Chemistry material.
Yeah. To be handled with gloves. Hello. My friends, as you all know, next week our adventure must come to an end. You also know that I'm no good at speeches, so I'll keep this brief. After all the years I spent with you here, I can honestly say I think of you as my family, but I'm going to miss you all. But before the fair closes, we've got one last week in business, and during this time I want you all to give the very best of yourselves, so the public never forgets us. So, before getting back to work, here's the list of jobs for the week. Roger, clean out the aquarium. Alice, kitchen. Tom, pest control. Martha, responsible for the keys to the place. Keith, upkeep of the rail and carriages. H. Ferguson.
The bearded lady kept the key to this exhibition. Interesting.
Right. Nobody else worried about the sheer volume of blood on the table. Okay, do we have photos?
The cage is held shut with this bar. It only needs to be pulled away to open it. This cage is still occupied, not by one of the monsters, but by a poor man.
Yeah.
He's still alive, but he's barely human now. Moriarty must have tested his poison on this poor fellow. If he was freed, he would leap at the throat of the first person he saw.
Yeah, so here's a thought. Don't.
I could easily open the cage by raising the door, but that poor man would leap on me immediately.
Okay. So don't be doing that then. Hello? That seems... odd.
Here's what I've been looking for.
Right. Now, what key have I just picked up?
It is the key to the main entrance door.
I'm inclined to say I need the crank, I think. What have we got? What is that? Why are you pinging at me? Don't ping at me.
Thanks to this mechanism.
Still missing, I think, part of the crank. Okay, so...
The cage is held shut. He's still...
Yeah, okay.
People must have been locked... The cage. I could easily open.
I know you could, yeah. Not the point. I see, I kind of want.
The crank is in place.
Oh, now you're letting me place it. Oh, thanks for that. Okay, so I've got the rope. Use a rope.
I could easily open the... I could easily... The cage is held...
I know. Okay, so can I use the crank?
The hook is above the cage of this poor wretch.
Right. We're getting somewhere.
There. The rope is in place.
The rope is miraculous, yeah. Shed load longer. See, that's leaning out the window. What I want R. Oh, it's not really giving me anything, is it?
This large empty.
Yes, I know. Okay, what have we got?
Chemistry material.
No, got nothing else there. See, my aim. I think. Ah! Duh. If I want to attract someone's attention, then knocking over those boxes of bottles will probably do the job.
These boxes are precariously balanced.
Well, let's precariously unbalance them. Really loath to do that.
This way I can open the poor fellow's cage from the outside without taking any risks. The trap is in place. Now I only need to get the guard to go inside the freak show.
Ah, hence the bottles.
Guard must have been warned. I need to get out of here. The guard is inside. I must close the door quickly.
You don't feel like, you know, moving at all.
Closed. I must find a way of neutralizing the guard inside.
Not a problem.
I can't do that.
Well, why not? Okay. Oh, this doesn't bode well for the guard. Okay, fish.
Well, I'll be leaving you. I'm sure you have a great many things to do.
Right. Back to where I was going then.
But what have we got here?
Ah, there you are, Holmes. Did you have any problems?
None, apart from a few small things. What have you found out about this warehouse?
Prince Woodville's soup is loaded and contaminated by hands.
And in the direction of Whitechapel. Watson, in a few hours, Moriarty will have at his disposal a formidable army, more powerful and more terrible than anything that has ever existed.
But what?
The soup is destined for a poverty-stricken, starving population who have been conditioned for months against the ruling powers. Moriarty won't have any trouble in sending thousands of raving mad people to ravage the city, sowing death and destruction. No force would be able to resist them, not the police, not even the army. A perfect army, knowing neither fear nor pity. A tidal wave of humanity which will cover London and will fall away again, leaving a city of desolation behind it.
What horror! And the chaos will only make Moriarty's coup d'etat even easier. But how will he guard himself against this bloodthirsty crowd?
The chaos will only last for the time he needs.
You mean to say...
that these poor wretches will all die. 48 hours after ingesting the soup, according to our good Dr. Shielman. So the victims will be joined by their executioners. An immense mass murder. What Moriarty would call clearing up after work, no doubt. Good. Have you found a way of stopping Hans's process?
Yes, I think so. If we can weaken the reservoir's feet with the explosives, for example, it will collapse and take the building down with it.
Good work.
What are you looking at?
Have you ever seen anything like this before?
Never.
It's on pay-per-view. Right. I feel a little silhouette of a save. And welcome back, Fishy. Okay. So what's going on here?
These caravans must be inhabited. Oh. Look, there is smoke coming out of one of them.
Aha, I feel a little creaky now. Well, there's a convenient slope left for me.
Look, Holmes, the three Russian brothers.
Ooh,
with a coal stove and dynamite.
What should we do next, Holmes?
And then the dynamite would be very useful for blowing up the tank.
Good idea. But in order that we can get it, we'll have to get them out of there without their knowing we are here. The best thing to do is to carry on exploring this place, Holmes.
Wacko. I'm getting a strong sense of... oops. Blocking the chimney up.
This ladder is only held back by a bolt.
Do I have a screwdriver?
This ladder is only held back by a bolt. It is the chimney pipe. It has been cut. Interesting.
Okay, what's up with the roof? Okay. Right, can't do anything there.
There is no one here, and nothing very interesting.
Okay.
This ladder is only held back by a bolt.
Okay. Can I get
closed?
Apparently not. Oh, there's all sorts of things. Comrades, the exploiters are thirsty. They want blood. They have no doubt about it. Basically standard manifesto time.
An international anarchist's manifesto written in several languages.
Okay.
A metal plate. Very solid.
Okay.
A wanted poster in Russian, with the portraits of the three brothers on it. A wanted poster.
Okay, yes, I've looked at that. No need to ping. That's it. Probably a lot loud in there. Hang on. That's where the bubbles are. So I haven't been this way yet. Hello.
This stall is a washroom. I can see water basins inside. The door can be blocked from the outside. Interesting.
Okay, so possibly block the chimney.
Gallons of vodka.
Sounds like a plan. And,
apparently they are more interested in games than in cleanliness.
Send them rushing for where they can get water to get smoke out of their eyes. Strikes me as quite a good idea. How do I implement it, though? They're pinging me again. Make the bad things stop. Oh, I wanted to go on the Helter Skelter. Oh, hello. Can I go on the Helter Skelter?
I pity the people who must have risked their lives in this attraction.
Worse. Oh, shit.
This place must have been magnificent.
Shh. Watson, look. On the stage. Prince Woodville.
Oh, clearly a poster child for sanity. I'm really hoping they're all dummies.
And it is with an immense pride that I take possession of the attributes of the crown and swear in front of you to serve my people with... Gentlemen, who are you? I don't believe I know you.
We...
Not as yet, Your Royal Highness, but I am overjoyed that you are familiar with the crowning ceremony.
Of course. A good king should know it.
That makes my duty so very much easier. Let me introduce myself. My name is Howard Sawbury, and I am in charge of the aforementioned protocol and the master of ceremonial events at Buckingham Palace.
How big is this
yes,
guy?
Yes, and I'm Sir John Kennard. In charge of the peacocks in the Royal Gardens.
Congratulations, Sir John. Excellent imagination.
I'm pleased to meet you, gentlemen, but what brings you here?
Do you mean to say that no one has informed you? Have you not been in the city? It is Queen Victoria, of course. She has been dethroned.
Really? So soon? According to my special advisor, Professor Moriarty, that should not take place until a few days from now.
The people have decided otherwise, sir, and now they're calling for their new sovereign, the benevolent, most understanding Prince Woodville.
Ah, gentlemen, you bring me great news. My good people have carried out their duty. I can finally take my rightful place. And happily before the bombs detonated.
Oh, can we kill this guy?
Actually, sir, we're here to warn you that you are in grave danger.
What do you mean?
Among your close advisors, I regret there are traitors who are already plotting against you. We have reliable information that these terrorists are part of an international anarchist network, and...
Ah, gentlemen, I know who you are talking about. I'm sure you mean the strange gentleman employed by Professor Moriarty. Asians or,
Russians, sir.
Whatever. These men must be stopped before their bombs explode.
Their bombs?
Yes, Sir John. Bombs placed all over London. I was not at all fond of the idea, but Professor Moriarty was quite adamant.
Do you know where these bombs are, precisely?
Of course not. But I do know that those anarchists created their exploding devices here.
You must tell us everything that you know about the bombs, sir.
Why should I? You're not a pyrotechnist, are you? I must speak urgently with Professor Moriarty.
Okay. So, do we tell him there's a bomb in the theatre? Do we say that Moriarty betrayed him? Or do we say, let's warn Moriarty? I personally would just like to punch this guy, but that's just me.
Sir, we're afraid that the beginning of your reign will be scarred by tragedy.
Whatever do you mean?
I think, however, that it is vital we arrest these terrorists. Tell me where their workshop is, I beg of you, in the name of the British Empire.
In a wooden stall between two tents, next to the Russian caravans.
Very well. We're going to search.
Wait. I demand an explanation. If everyone is plotting against me, how do I know that you are not also party to the plot?
But we...
Bring me Professor Moriarty, Mr. Sawbury, without delay. Sir John will remain here with me.
I should be able to remove the prince without endangering Watson's life.
Right. Okay, back we go.
In return, you must understand that this places me in a somewhat disagreeable situation.
Yes, I understand, but the reasons of the state...
Telekinesis.
I know.
Walls
I
today.
Here to render you a service. Come now,
let us be serious for one... So, Prince Woodville is completely balmy.
You underestimate not only me, sir, but also my birds. I believe that a prominence...
These tangled ropes are holding back the curtains.
Oh, I feel the puzzle coming on. Okie dokie. Beyond these ropes should not cross. Well, that's not good. Then you just made it hugely worse. These ropes are apparently infinitely elastic. So I think the aim of the game is to uncross all these ropes. I am, however, height limited. Thank you. down can I take these? How far up can I take those? The question is, can I get all this done in this amount of space? I don't see how that works. So it's just those two. Yes. Jump up and down on him. Kick him. You have him.
He's not moving. He appears to have passed out.
But he could come around at any moment and sound the alarm.
Yes, before leaving the theatre, we must make certain that that does not happen.
Not so long ago, those words coming from you would have frozen my blood.
Rest assured, my friend, that Sherlock Holmes no longer exists.
Get rid of him now.
Right.
There is a label underneath this lever. Magician's trap door, middle of the stage. Exactly where the prince is standing.
Okay.
Hey, presto, it's magic. No more paranoid prince.
Well done, Holmes. Look, Holmes, Prince Woodville lost his ring during the fight.
Excellent, let's steal it. It wasn't a fight, unless he was fighting with a curtain.
There is an enormous diamond in the middle of this ring. I will give it to the police later.
Honest.
We must find...
Yes, I know.
This magician has a leather belt, very solid. There is a small bag attached to it.
Loot the bodies! What have I got? Okay. Apparently I'm not allowed to look at it.
What were these dummies at the front of the stage used for?
The prince put them there to represent his public.
Prince was batshit barking bonkers. The magician's white powder. Uh-huh. Right. So I've got magician's white powder, and I know roughly where the anarchists have this. Did I come in through the other bit? And does it matter? Right.
This lad...
I know. Can I use anything on it?
We must find...
Yeah, I know. Get out of the way, you idiot.
This ladder...
It's only held back by a bolt that I apparently can't do anything with. Right. Good-o. Bastard. Buggering things locked on me. Come on. And the question of the day is, how do you get at the task manager when it's on the other monitor and hidden behind the window that's crashed on? When in doubt, cheat. So, back in the room, hopefully, and unfortunately I've got to do that bloody rope puzzle again. No, not yet. I'm just relaunching. It's more like it. See how much we've lost, shall we? Bollocks. Right, what have I got? Yep, okay, I've got to go through that thing in the theatre again. However, I ought to be able to do so.
These caravans must be inhabited. Look, there is smoke coming out of one of them.
With a degree of alacrity, Yaddy yaddy yaddy, yeah, obsessive manifesto, whatever.
An international... A metal plate. Very solid.
Have a look at the bathroom.
This stall is a wash. Apparently, they're gallons of vodka.
Lashings of ginger beer. Or something.
Look, Holmes. The three Russian brothers.
With a coal...
What should we do next, Holmes?
And then the dynamite would...
Good idea. The best...
Yep. So, yeah, that's the plan. Right. So the theatre is this way. And by the way, Fish, you should now be seeing a game. Could you do me a favour and confirm that yes, you can?
This place must...
Gentlemen?
We...
Of course.
That makes... Congratulations.
I'm pleased.
Do you mean... To...
Really?
The people...
Ah.
Okay, yep.
Actually, sir...
What do you mean?
Among...
Ah, gentlemen. Russians. Whatever.
They're bo...
Yes, Sir John.
Do you know...
Of course.
You must have...
Why...
Sir.
Whatever do you...
In a wooden... Very well...
Wait.
But we...
Bring me Professor Moriarty, Mr. Sawbury. Without delay. Sir John will remain here with me.
I should be able to remove the prince without endangering Watson's life.
I should. Doesn't mean I'm going to. Yay, handy.
I understand, sir, but in return you must understand that this places me in a somewhat disagreeable situation.
There is a late... I can't do that. These tang...
Right. Let's see if I can remember how to do this. Way easier solution than I came up with last time. Okay, single player. Or are you somewhere new, Fish?
But he could...
Yes, before leaving the theatre.
Not so long ago.
Rest assured, my friend. Get rid of him now.
Hey, presto. It's magic. No more paranoid prince.
Well done, Holmes. Look, Holmes. We must find...
There is an enormous diamond in the middle of this ring. I will give...
We must find...
Yes, yes.
What were these dummies?
The prince put them there to represent his public.
The prince was out of his tiny. Ah.
This magician...
Right, now we save, because I'm not doing that a third time. Let's go and get some points and have a look at the Helter Skelter.
I pity the people who must have risked their lives in this attraction.
Obviously. Right.
This ladder. The illusionist's smoke powder.
Okay.
Abracadabra.
Magic powder and a metal plate. The revolutionaries won't resist it. Hide, Watson.
I really hope I hide.
Water. Water.
Yep, there we go.
The way is clear. Perfect.
I can hear the chinking of a bottle and talk in Russian. The three brothers are quietly getting drunk. Perfect. We must hurry, Holmes. Each chime tells us that the preparation of the poison soup is advancing.
I'm coming, Watson. I just need to unblock the chimney.
I've been trying to move you so you can do that. But no, Penny, I have to wait. Let me take back my plate. There we go.
This caravan is as disgusting as the first one.
Right. Your peddlers of freedom must be placed as soon as possible on the following targets. Oh, you bastard!
The names of the targets are written in Russian and are unreadable, in my case, that is, and apparently the brothers have made notes before every name.
Handy.
The dynamite shells are empty. A pity.
What on earth? I'm not even going to ask.
This piece of art shows the hatred the anarchists feel towards Prince Woodville and everything he represents.
And yet they were working with him, you know.
Wire!
Right.
Let's see.
Ah. Psycho Russian, Russian Psycho Dictionary. No, wait, hang on. Right. That one? I keep reading that as Bayaki. Bick. Bick UH. Oh, what? I know. Oh, right, okay. I was only seeing the bottom. So, whatever on earth that is. Nakata? Possibly?
That's not right.
Okay, so A something. So Stonehenge A God, R possibly? So the House of Commons? CK. What the hell is that? Okay, so Bick something.
That's not right.
No, damn. Oh, Buckingham Palace. The H. I can't even find that. Oh, yeah, there it is. H-A... whatever that hell is. Bank of England. All the places of power.
If these bombs explode, then I believe that the realm will be plunged into one of the gravest crises in its history.
What are you going to do with this information, Holmes?
Hand it across to Inspector Lestrade.
How?
By telephoning him. The haunted house is connected to the telephone exchange. I'm going to try to slip in there discreetly.
Shall I accompany you?
You can help me to get in, but while I search for the telephone, you should collect as much information as you can about the bombs. The explosive experts at Scotland Yard will need it.
Understood.
Anything else in here I haven't yet picked up? What have I got? Hello? What are you?
A small saw. Ah, we might need this.
Those ladders are only held back by bolts. Do we think that those bolts might be vulnerable to a hacksaw? I think it might be. I also think that you're going to have to put up with me paranoically saving the game rather more than normal.
This ladder.
Yeah, okay.
This ladder is not too heavy. I can carry it.
Probably in my coat. Yep. He's got it hidden in his trousers.
This ladder is not.
Do we have a third? No. Two small ladders. One large ladder. For reasons known to somebody who isn't me. I've got a ladder. Yay! Ooh, that's not good fish.
Look, Holmes, there appears to be some sort of control panel.
With an antenna, whatever its purpose might be.
Well, I can't imagine it's anything good, can you? Mad bombers. Which I'm trying really hard not to see as the Bolshevik Muppet. May need to be Watson. Get out of my way. Oh, yeah, that's a bit of a flaw. If you can't build up enough O2 reserves, what are you going to do?
Telephone line. Interesting. It comes from that large building.
Should I have stayed there? I should, shouldn't I? Okay. Sorry, Watson, we're going back this way. Down to Omicron being a total git, or is it that you're in a particularly unpleasant bid? So that'd be the haunted house then.
I can hear noises. We aren't alone. We had best be careful.
Okay. We are not alone. Hello, what's this?
It seems that this window is more vulnerable than the main door.
I think it is too high. It's protected by bars with a closed window behind it.
I've got a ladder, a saw, and a diamond.
I could saw through the bars, being careful to create a passage wide enough.
Okay. Really? You're making me saw each bar individually? We'll pretend that Watson just caught that.
No, it is unnecessary. No, it is unnecessary. No, it would be better not to break the window. It would make too much noise. No, it is unnecessary. No, it is unnecessary. No, it is unnecessary. No, it is unnecessary.
A good idea to use the diamond in the ring, Holmes. Exactly like at the Marquis's place.
I remind you of the monkey that's...
Well done, Holmes.
It's open. It's time for me to go into the beast's lair.
Hi, Duncan
Sanity. Watson, I have no idea how long it will take me to locate the telephone.
Duncan Sanity, Wallace.
Use the time to try to get into the stand where the bombs were put together.
I'm on my way. I'll join you later.
You control Dr. Watson. Apparently Holmes doesn't give a shit. Can I pick up the ladder? Can I ducks? Right. So. It's a shack between the anarchists' caravan.
The place is calm, thanks to the supply of vodka in the washroom. The anarchists probably haven't even noticed that they're locked in.
Mind by me.
The Russian's workshop is here. The padlock appears very solid.
Right, and Watson has absolutely nothing. Oh, goody!
I need to find some information.
Yes, yes you do. Right. Sherlock.
Locked.
Oh, come on. So the boring one's not locked. Yay. Nothing in this caravan. I need to get into the one in the middle, I suspect. Right. Well, of course you'd take the watering can.
There must be water here.
Yes, well spotted there.
The fire in this stove hasn't been put out, and now it's overheating. It must be stopped quickly.
Okay.
It's too hot. I'll burn my hand.
Oh, for God's sake.
a large dry cloth.
Okay. So a tea towel.
Oh, it was time. Lard. Were they really going to eat that?
Not sure what this says about Russian cuisine in the minds of the writers.
A key.
Yeah. I was more concerned about what actually was being cooked in that, given that this is where the anarchists were living who've been making dynamite.
Very pretty Russian dolls. Let's see if there's something inside. A key.
Another key. Yay. If you need a clue to complete a Russian doll, then you probably lack a brainstem.
Whittling wooden objects seems to be a passion of one of the brothers. After building explosive devices, of course.
That's more of a hobby.
It's an ornately carved toy chest. According to the name marked on it, it belongs to a certain Alexei. And it's locked by a key.
Are we going to say it's actually a toy chest rather than a toy chest? Okay, what do we got?
A bag of marbles. They're marvellous. A clock's hand. Strange handymen, these anarchists. A pretty spinning top.
If you like grey. Letter in Russian.
Okay. A Cyrillic letter with a strange symbol.
Anything else in there? What if that symbol's on the lock? If not, we've got problems.
I need something.
Well, what else do you need? Yes, I was wondering if that was him. Her? It?
Locked.
Alright.
I need something.
I'm hoping what you need is the hand of a clock. That's just me.
I need...
Ah. One of them, is it?
I've already seen this symbol on a piece of paper I found inside the anarchist's chest.
intended to do. That was the...
It's not very difficult after all. Another three carts full of poison soup. I must hurry.
Hurry into the room full of explosives, because I'm sure that will go well.
So it's here that the three anarchists made their bombs. But what a mess. Very well, I don't have any choice. If I want to understand how they work, I will have to build one.
What? What kind of logic leap is that? I have no knowledge of explosives or how to use it. I must therefore build a bomb...
A crowbar.
...out of crap I found in a shed. You're not following Watson's logic. No role player in the world.
Here's the bench for assembling the explosive devices.
Okay.
There's something here.
Oh, good. Oh, hello. Because, of course, you would. No, it's close, but no cigar. Done the same thing again, haven't I? Well, that needs to go there. That needs to go. No. Okay. Ah. There needs to be a turn the paper over because I'm fairly sure that's all I need to do. Yes, he does. Ah, now I can fold in.
A plan for Russian bombs on a Japanese origami to blow up key places in England. Very cosmopolitan.
For fuck's sake. This plan
shows the steps to follow for building a bomb.
So, one, dynamite. Two, a board. Jesus.
That's of no use. That's of no use.
No, okay.
That's of no use. That's of no use. That's of no use. That's of no use. That's of
no... No, okay. So, I... Oh, have I? Have I?
Locked.
Crowbar.
Sticks of dynamite.
Don't sound so happy and for the God's sake. Don't build them in your pocket.
This box contains a jumble of radio receivers and boxes of copper wire.
I and he doesn't just upend the entire box onto the table. Oh boy. Yeah, really not sure what your logic is here, John. That's it for this room. How to build a better bomb, then? Step one, take your dynamite. Step two, take your board.
That's of no use. That's of no use.
Step three, step four, I was hoping that that...
Apparently the radio is plugged in.
Good, good. What? Step five, timer. Hope everyone's paying attention, you know, DIY Al-Qaeda kit. Step six, bits of wire, at random. Step seven, a bottle of alcohol, because why not? And step eight, a handle to wind the entire thing up. Yes, it's only a relatively short Strutter stream, because Strutty is going out to wave swords around in a while, but I didn't think I had much left on Holmes. And as it turns out, I'm right. But for some reason, Dr. Watson's building a better bomb. Is that not done?
Oops, the switch doesn't work. Don't panic, John. All you need to do is to find another way to defuse it.
What?
The best thing will be for me to go to the merry-go-round with my bomb.
Can somebody please do me a favour, because I can't tab out and quote that? What the hell?
I'll take the bomb with me. Oh, it's heavy.
Terrible urge to not run under any circumstances. Oh my god. Right, you're at the merry-go-round. Why? I probably better save this actually, because I think Watson's about to turn into sushi. The best thing would be for me to go to the merry-go-round with my bomb. Oh, I can't get that one. Okay.
Thanks to this radar, I can perhaps disconnect my bomb.
Sorry? Oh, come on, I just got it.
I'll have to start again. I must have done something wrong.
There. Yes. Okay.
Oh my God. Now I understand. The antenna on the merry-go-round controls all the bombs that the Russian brothers made. The control panel. It works. Thanks to this, I think we can now disconnect all the bombs that have been spread around London. And mine too.
Oh, good. Good. Can you?
The control panel. We can branch a telephone here to call Lestrade. I must warn Holmes.
Right. So, back to the haunted house, I think. Yeah. I love the fact he still hasn't deactivated his bomb. What's that? Wandering around with a live bomb. It's fine. I wish it wasn't flashing.
I must warn Holmes.
Yes, I'd love to warn Holmes, but unfortunately I can't warn Holmes.
I'm going to throw a marble at the window, which will attract Holmes's attention if he's there.
Of course it will. Because after defusing a bomb on the merry-go-round, of course you throw marbles at the window.
Holmes isn't there. Let's try another window.
Oh, fantastic. Okay. Come back through this way. No, right. Okay. That's a window, which apparently I can't do anything with.
I'm going to throw a marble at the...
Holmes, I've got the bomb.
Holmes isn't answering. It would be better to wait until he reaches the room where the telephone is.
Okay. Oh, do I get to be Holmes again? Meanwhile, while Watson has decided...
This room is clean and well kept. What a contrast to the filth throughout the rest of the fair.
What a contrast to don't you freaking dare. Okay, it's auto-saving. Right, thank God for that.
I know this book. The Dynamics of an Asteroid. It is the reference book written by Moriarty. I must be in his bedroom.
How do you know that he keeps such things in his bedroom? How many times have you been in Moriarty's bedroom?
These paintings are extremely precious. They are the original works of great masters.
As opposed to the unoriginal works of mediocre masters. Right. Well, since I'm burgling the guy.
That could be useful.
Yes, yes. Why not?
That could be useful.
Take all the sheets. Yes, I believe he's read the book.
A magnificent hunting rifle. This glass cabinet is locked, but I should be able to force the lock.
Or use the diamond ring that apparently...
No, it... No, it is unnecessary. No, it is unnecessary. No, it is unnecessary.
Worse.
No, it is unnecessary.
Got a rope. I don't know why I've got a rope, but I've got a rope.
A key.
You could force the lock, or you could use the key. Which is probably to something other than the lock.
This chest is the same as Ferguson the Magician's.
Oh, God.
No, I can't do that.
Okay.
This padlock seems rather old. This padlock.
Okay. Can I use pliers on it? Yes, I can.
A doll. It is new. It was bought recently.
You dirty, dirty man, Mekiador. Do like you. By the present transfer, Mr. B. Trommery becomes the owner of the totality of the parts yielded from this day on with all the rights that are attached to the transfer. Notably, he will possess the only rights to the products of the said parts, which shall be put into distribution at a later date. To that purpose, Mr. H. Ferguson, transferor, abandons to Mr. B. Trommery all of his rights and shares resulting from the possession of the parts transferred.
The Funfair's Act of Transfer, signed by that poor Ferguson. Moriarty didn't spare him, anyway. This pin could be useful.
That doll is just incredibly creepy. I feel the need to save. Right.
A magnificent hunting...
Yes, all right. Okay, here we go.
That's not right. No. Start again.
There we go. That's more like it. Yes.
This weapon is unusable. The hammer is missing. One can never be too careful.
Locked and disabled.
Here is everything to take care of this magnificent rifle.
So after all that, you're taking oil. That's it. Okay. Anything else in this room? No. I love the fact there's guards by the dozen outside, but apparently nothing here.
Wooden skeleton. Nice element of decor.
As you do. Ah, what's that?
If I attach the rope here, I can go down without being seen.
It's always good to go down without being seen.
If I attach the rope...
Okay.
This place has been fitted out as a command center and as living quarters for Moriarty.
Very well. Everything will be done as you wish. Above all, don't get impatient. I'll do the necessary.
That's good to know.
Moriarty is here. Apparently he is very busy. And this is curious. He seems to be obeying his interlocutor. Moriarty is a hired hand.
Ooh, yes, Mask of the Red Death. Fishy. That does look like a good game.
It would be better.
I don't want to go down there.
These shelves seem solid.
Thank you. I'll fit them in my pants of holding. Alright, okay, can't go that way. So, time to go down unseen.
Now I can go down.
Off you go. Whee! Apparently Holmes climbs down head first. Labyrinth. So, walls have left.
These partitions are on pivots. At the bottom, there appears to be a set of cogs upon which a wheel is fixed. It is rusty. If I turn the wheel, it is possible that the mechanism...
Just as well I've got oil then, isn't it, mate? Yes, no, maybe? Of a labyrinth, is it? There are more sensible things to do. Let's go back up and see what that's done for me. Because I'm not happy about just strolling into that room with the guard there. Okay. Okay. Holmes has done the Krypton Factor. Don't pick it up again, you moron. Good, because I feel happy about this. Right. Okay. Meanwhile, Moriarty's basically looking with a...
What? I can't do that.
Okay, so where do I need to go? I need that door open. Right, okay. So... now it was up at the end, wasn't it? Right, back we go. Should take me across.
I need something.
There we go. I have crossed to the other side.
It would be better not to go down there.
Yes, don't go down there.
It would be better not to go down there. Closed.
Do we have a key? We have a key. Thank you. We have a telephone.
Another bell ringing in the warehouse. That is not a good sign.
It's also not a bell.
Let's hurry.
Don't worry, Watson's probably just built another bomb.
Ah, here is the famous telephone.
Hello?
South London Exchange. What number do you want?
1313, Scotland Yard. Please hurry.
One moment.
I know that voice.
Lestrade here.
It's Sherlock Holmes.
Holmes! You're alive!
An excellent deduction, Lestrade. Now listen to me carefully. I'll get straight to the point. Moriarty has had four bombs placed around London, all of which could go off at any moment. You absolutely must find them and defuse them.
How can I believe what you say? You are being hunted by all the police in the kingdom.
They were looking for me, yes, but not any longer. You called off the search when my death was announced. Logically, why would I call you if I was not innocent? You must begin the search for those bombs straight away.
That's true enough. So where are the bombs?
Buckingham Palace, the House of Commons, the Bank of England. And as for the last one, it is entirely possible that you are sitting on it.
Scotland Yard?
Yes. Mobilize all your men and find them, but don't touch them without the defusing instructions.
Don't touch your men.
Luckily, those locations are already under heavy police guard. What are the defusing instructions?
Don't know.
I don't have the details at present, but Watson is working on it. Stay near the telephone. I'll call you back the instant we find out. Curious. I can hear something tapping at regular intervals against the shutters.
Thank you.
Watson?
I think I know what we must do in order to defuse the bombs, Holmes.
Good work, Watson.
Yes, well, no, not really, because the bomb I have with me, the...
Ah, I think I understand. How do you always manage to get yourself into these situations?
How often does he build
bombs? I didn't really have any choice in the matter.
It's primed, isn't it?
I'm afraid so, and I need you to stop it.
Paco.
Perfect.
We need to go to the merry-go-round. Can you bring the telephone with you?
Well, I hope you know what you are doing.
You'll understand when you see the control panel installed under the merry-go-round. But please hurry. I really would like to get rid of this infernal device.
On the contrary, we must keep a careful hold of it. We are going to use it to destroy the warehouse where the soup is made. Step aside. I'm going to jump.
With the telephone?
Quite simply, Holmes. The bombs all have a switch that allows them to be defused.
But it's not as simple as that, is it?
No, of course not. The bombs are also linked up with the merry-go-round's antenna by a radio frequency. And that wavelength is a security to stop the switches on the bombs from operating. Therefore, they must be disconnected from the merry-go-round.
But that's not all. If no one switches them off, they will explode anyway.
So that is why you need the telephone.
We need to call Lestrade to tell him when to turn off the switches.
Well done, Holmes. You have understood.
You are reversing the roles, Watson. Highly amusing.
Well, we can laugh about it later, but now we must hurry.
A telephone line. It goes to the haunted house.
Right. Nope, can't get up that way. I'm on a strict time limit here. I've only got 15 minutes and I need to finish this. I'm hoping there's not much more to this game. It would be highly aggravating to have to come back for a short encore.
First of all, we must plug in the telephone.
I'm hoping you picked it up.
First of all...
Oh, all right then.
Perfect.
Oh, no. Right. What? Who? Okay, you're confusing me now. All right, okay. Right, so that's those two. Those two? I don't know what's going on. Okay, things are lighting up. Let's go with things lighting up. Two things light up. Okay. Everything lights up. Nope. Oh. Okay, so I need to light up. I think the orange is next. That's that pair. So that then should be yellow and blue, I think, for those two.
Hurry up, Holmes.
Oh, shut up. Okay, so what? Orange, I think?
Buckingham has been switched off. Scotland Yard has been switched off.
Yes, orange, orange. Blue, blue, logically, because I've got orange, blue.
The Bank of England has...
I think I've just blown up the kingdom. Why is that not lit? Orange, yellow. Yellow. Oh, yellow and blue again! Right, okay. So that needs to be orange. That still needs
Parliament
orange.
Has been... That's it, Holmes.
Right.
The bombs are disconnected.
You can use the switches now.
Okay.
Let's
London
hide,
up.
Holmes.
The bombs were due to explode 5 minutes ago. You, go and get the anarchists and take them to the warehouse. Stay there. I'm going to the warehouse to check on the soup.
Let's get out of here.
Holmes, where are we going?
Watson, what do you intend to do with that primed bomb at your feet?
My God, there's not much time left.
It would certainly be more useful elsewhere. Come, let us go, and let us try not to ruin the last chance we may have to save London.
To save the game. Right then. I think we probably want to be going back.
The guards have deserted the door. Now's our chance.
To amble gently.
I don't think that I told you about this siren.
No, but I can guess that it carries some connection with the poisoned soup.
Without going into too much detail, the next time that it sounds, the carts will leave to stock up Prince Woodville's network throughout London.
And it will be impossible to prevent the population from being poisoned.
We must hurry. Moriarty's men are looking for us. The soup production is nearly finished, and I am carrying a primed bomb in my hands.
No, you're not. You're clearly carrying it in your trousers.
Quick, jump into the cable car.
Swiftly to the rescue.
Uh-oh.
There they are! Hey! Hey!
They've seen us.
There they are, boss. In the cable car.
The esteemed Sherlock Holmes. Back among the living. I am afraid that your resurrection can only be a temporary one at best.
Have we ever been in such a perilous situation before?
Very rarely, I must admit.
Well, gentlemen, what are you waiting for? Are you afraid, Holmes?
Yeah. Amble.
The bomb is on the point of exploding. Moriarty's men can't shoot us like rabbits or restart the cable car and catch us on the warehouse roof. We are trapped.
Moriarty wants us alive. That much is evident. So let us take advantage of the few minutes we have left.
Okay. Bomb in the bucket, anyone? Yes! Oh my God, I can put the bomb in the bucket. Yes! Leather bomb in the bucket. Oh,
perfect.
Great.
I understand, Holmes. Fine. Leave everything.
Any danger of you actually doing something? that lever that sends us the other way. Could that not be a plan? Moriarty says bollocks to it. that lever. Anytime.
The lever is stuck.
Of course it is.
The lever is stuck.
Not judging.
If we don't find a
search, Watson.
What are you doing?
The manual emergency system is behind this trapdoor.
Oh, that's good to know.
It works. We are safe here.
Yes, there are only a few seconds left before...
Hug-a-boom. That's killing the ecosystem of the entire area.
My God, what a yeah. Shock. Moriarty, he was in the warehouse. This time, it's over, Holmes.
The mysterious person whom Moriarty appears to obey.
Whoever could be powerful enough to command Moriarty?
The devil. Probably Moriarty himself, actually. That was probably an actor. Right. Somebody was at the haunted house. I do wonder if it was the poisoner. He had his will-manipulating potion. Otherwise known as Roofy. Right.
The doors are wide open. Perhaps we are too late.
I don't think so.
Why do you feel the need to autosave? Moriarty kaboom. Okay.
Don't touch that door! Get back!
Damn you, Holmes! Damn you!
Oh dear, he's not happy.
So, you survived the explosion.
Professor, put down your gun. I am going to examine your wounds.
Don't come any closer. I don't need a doctor.
It is over, Moriarty.
You need the doctor.
You have failed.
Not entirely. Your death will lessen the defeat.
Him.
We have failed, Holmes. You and I.
In that case, I cannot imagine that you would refuse to answer the last question of the condemned.
A question.
Why has he got a nose?
You can ask it of the devil, Holmes.
Is Shielman immune to his own poison?
What?
Dead.
Don't leave her alone, Holmes.
Oh.
I always tried to do my best for her. Only you are worthy to teach her. Take her.
Uh-huh. Okay. Blink, blink. Poltergeist. Why has she got the 11th Doctor on her sideboard? Apparently she suffers from a really stiff neck.
I don't know if my feelings could ever equal those of my friend. But as he walked off into the night, carrying that little girl in his arms, I confess that I had never seen him so moved. Holmes became the child's father. He gave her a gentle but exacting education.
Whole insanity bit in the next but one game.
He finally realized, thanks to this child, the simple happiness that life could bring, and also something that had previously always escaped him, love.
Okay. Right. Well, we shall call an end to that then. I hope everybody enjoyed that. I hope somebody enjoyed that. Not too sure about the Bond ending here. Which is just weirding me out. So that's time to go nicely because I absolutely now have to go. So, thank you all so much for watching. And thank you, Vicky, for picking us up. Crimes and Punishments are the only remaining one of the later games, which is set between this and the that will be the next one, which I will leave for a little while, probably until New Year. Give me time to have a bit of a palate cleanser and get over some of the insanity that Frogwares has inflicted on me. So, let's have a quick look at my honours, which is most of them. I didn't get Blackmailer. Okay, I'll live with that. So, thank you very much, and good night. Well, good evening, anyway. I don't know if Fishy's going to still be streaming Imperion, or other people. I'm not swinging swords at people, maybe. I hope. Otherwise, I don't doubt the Boris is up to something. Nightbites won't be because he'd be muted personally. So have a good evening, and I shall see you around.